they're very exciting tutorial.
In today's creation process, we'll be making a logo. So in Illustrator, this is Illustrator, and in Illustrator we're going to make a logo. I'll take a circle and just fill up the color. I'll remove the outline while you're making any design. Now if you need it, you can use the outlines. But at this point, I don't need the outlines. So next, I'll take a ruler for correct measurement. So Control R for ruler and bring out the ruler. Once your ruler is being done, using the pen tool you can add or remove the anchor point, and after that you can remove the rulers when it's not necessary. So to do then, for my design I duplicate one more, just one more piece, and the flag rotated to an angle. And after that I'll take a cube and draw over the design, and I just want to subtract this portion, so use the Pathfinder to subtract it. In this way I have recreated one more design and using the same process. Let's subtract that sort of piece from that design using the Pathfinder. Scale it a little bit from sideways. Adjust the way in equal proportion. And then I'll combine this. Combine the portions. To combine everyone, you have to select all and just click on the combine first option of the Pathfinder. Now for to give a texture, that's a layer texture. I'll just make our cuboid and place it over it, and I'll duplicate a few more cuboid over it. Just give some angle in between them and just keep on making a few more cuboid. We need to form a design, so we'll make a few more cuboid like this. I'm changing the color of the cube so that I can it's identical, it's different from each other, so that it would be easier for me to recognize. You can duplicate any object using the R Alt by clicking Alt and dragging with the mouse. Sorry. The stuff which I'm doing right now is totally quite different. So you need to see it carefully. I'm duplicating the of that design which is on the first one using the layer tool. I'm just dragging and dropping on the layer of the sign, and it's getting duplicated over it. This step is to color each layer to give some shade of color. So I'm using pink and shade of a color. And before that, just select all the object and go and expand. It will save and then group all of it and group it and delete all the unused graphics. And now just to ensure your design to be perfect, just select these rows by clicking shift and combine it so that it remains as one piece. And once it's done, you can use the different color associates so that it look different, it look like a 3D or a catchy glow. While designing a logo, it's very important to create a unique design and eye catchy. And it should also imply there should be a strong sense of color. Sometimes your screen display doesn't work good because your screen doesn't show the exact color which is going to be used. So it's better to use the readings of the color. And this way, just apply different shades of color. Once your shade of color is complete, just recorrect the colors. And after that, I'm just adjusting the size so that I could put a text beside the logo, beside the design. So I'm writing logo, and while preparing a logo, it's very important that you do not use the original format. You need to edit few of your text so that it's going to be original. It's not made by someone else, it's made by you here. And the designs should look smart and cool and unique, so where there is edgy stuff you can remove it by adding anchor points and using pen tools. You can adjust them in whatever you will. Make sure once you completed your design, if you don't need any kind of recreation or you don't want to make any changes in the design, you just select all the pieces and just go and combine it. And after that, just I'm thinking tagline like linear logos or whatever. I'm using a text, small text. So give like a tagline feel in logo. Maintain your font size and fonts and give spaces when it's necessary. So guys, this is the way you can prepare your logo, a professional logo. And it's very important that you know where to place your text, where to put your design and how you can manage your color. So guys, thank you very much for watching the tutorial. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to see the next upcoming tutorial. Thank you very much. Love you guys. See you.